Hey guys, welcome back to Planet Coaster. I'm Arithia and today we're finishing the sci-fi area. I thought this would take me 2 episodes, but since we're doing things a little bit different from now on, this will go a lot faster. This being the last episode of the sci-fi area now maybe just seems a little bit sudden because we still have so much open space. But most of it will be filled in with foliage because, like I said before, I'm lagging pretty heavily and I have big plans for the fantasy area still, so I have to limit myself a little bit here. We will work on 2 flood rides, the monorail station, and a few other little things like some plant life, and we'll work on something for an entertainment point. So now that I finally decided that I would use some plant life in this area, and quite a bit as well, then I could kind of do something that I wanted to do in the first place, which was kind of these structures hidden in the forest, like monuments, which we will mark with these pillars that I used before that you see over here. So for this first one, as you can see, I made the monorail like a bridge so that the helium ring would fit underneath it. I thought that would be a pretty cool idea, and by building something pretty simple like you see here, mostly built with the ship wings, we have our first monument, and with some plant life around it, and I will be doing a lot of terraforming. I did that off screen, so I will just show you how that looks in real time. But yeah, now we're moving on to the monorail station. It's gonna be a fairly basic design. I didn't have that much inspiration for it. I kind of looked around on Google for a lot of images and stuff like that, but I just couldn't really figure out what I wanted to do here. It was like maybe I put everything I had into the facility. It's a pretty big building and I just kind of went with it. And we also did the coaster station, of course, and everything around that. So I kind of was burned out on this style a little bit at this point. But it turned out okay. Not every building can be your best, of course. And I still kind of like it, though. It works well enough for this, what we're doing here. Just creating the basics here, making sure the path will work out with what I did have in mind, which wasn't a lot. We'll create one wall, just design one wall and use that all over the building. I took a week off. I hope you guys weren't too bothered by the long wait. I really had to take some time to rethink things a little bit. Like I said, I'm kind of lacking inspiration and I felt like I was getting a little bit sick, and that was the case. I had the flu, probably like everyone else in the Netherlands right now, but I'm getting better and I'm full of inspiration again, so that's really good news. I'm really ready to do this and continue on with this. Really excited for the fantasy area. That is something that is just way more natural to me. I don't really need to take inspiration from anything else. I can just go with the flow and it turns out the way I want it often. So that's really nice for me. Definitely at this point where I'm getting a little bit burned out, like I said, not only on one theme, but also a little bit on Planet Coaster. I've been talking about this a lot less episodes. That's probably a sign that I'm really bothered by that. And I'm sorry if that comes across a little bit like I'm whining or something, but I now just feel like everything is fine again. It's really weird how you go through these motions and at one point you're just like for a few weeks, oh, I don't know if I can do this, I don't know if I can come up with something new again and again and again. But at this point I'm just back, so that's really good. I'm really full of inspiration again and full of energy to continue this on, and I'm really excited to start the fantasy area. So if you haven't seen last episode, I decided for a few different reasons that I would speed this series up a little bit. And I will be doing that by trying to build more and being a little bit more selective in what I show you in speed build. Of course, we'll make up for that in real time so you get a clear picture of what was done. And since we're starting with the fantasy area, I'm pretty sure I can manage. That's just a style, like I said, that works for me without too much thought into it. I've been drawing it out even, and I pretty much have the layout set for the fantasy area. So I have to say I'm really happy with the changes. You always hear me speak about how I want it to progress on a certain pace, and I was still really searching for what works best. I'm still growing and learning a lot. It only has been 8 months since we're making videos. It seems like a long time already, but yeah, I've been growing so much and learning so much and just getting to know you guys and see what you guys like and don't like. So it's a lot of trial and error, and I finally feel like I'm getting to a place where I understand what I actually want myself instead of only what you guys would like. So that's also a really good thing. So I just want to say thank you so much if you're still here and watching my series. Hear me ramble on about what my thought process was behind everything, which can be all over the place every now and then. So just thank you so much for motivating me as well in the comments. You guys have been absolutely amazing. So yeah, let's just continue on and let's do it better from now on. And that wraps up the monorail station. So now we're moving on with the collider. I absolutely love this ride. It's one of the newer ones. Did we get this one with the winter update? I think so. But yeah, I've been waiting to use this one over here for a while now. I was definitely planning on using this one from the moment we got it. Now, working a bit on the paths and the queue lines. And this is also something I'm gonna do a little bit more from now on. Because I make episodes, I try to really work in one spot and just finish what I started. So most of the time I would just leave this queue line as it is and I would work that in later. So I would just keep working on the collider. But from now on, whenever I feel like I have to finish something up in between, I will just do that, because that just is something that works a little bit better for me. And it can be maybe a little bit confusing in an episode when I go all over the place, but that is normally how I build. So I want to get back a little bit to how I would do things before I started overthinking it, because I do it for other people now as well. Now, I know this wasn't very confusing because it's just pathing, but if I would do other things and I would just go all over the place, it might get a little bit confusing, but I'll make sure that it works well enough. This one is gonna be really, really simple. I'm just basically gonna place, I think, about 6 pillars around it. I will later on design a lamppost. I don't even think I put that in the episode, but I can show you in real time how that looks, and I will put those between that. So we have this really basic looking monument, but it looks really cool. Not everything has to be really complicated. That's something when you get into the flow of making things the best that you can do it, you often forget that something simple can work really well. Alright, moving on to some trees over here, and I will basically place a few of them inside of each other, and that sounded kind of dirty, but you know what I mean, and this way we'll get a fairly, yeah, different look. And over here you're starting to see that frames just skip by and you won't see half of it because the lag was so bad that you will even see it when it's sped up like this. Even when I edit pieces out, you will still see it. So I'm sorry for that. That is something that I'm gonna fix very soon. I also want to make like mini cinematics about each section. First, I really need to get some more RAM so it won't be so laggy. 8 is just not good enough anymore for most games, so I'm going to get 32. Then I'm probably done for a while, so yeah. The lag is now starting to show through even when I speed it up, so that's just not acceptable for me at all, and I will just have to fix that. You will probably see a few weird looking skips like you saw before, or it's mostly freezes every now and then. Definitely in real time, but I will fix that soon. Placing some lights inside of it, so everything in this area looks really, really magical in the dark, because everything is just really focused on lights. This area should actually only be viewed in the dark, probably. I do love the total look of it. It just looks really magical, and it's not really only sci-fi, it's more sci-fi fantasy, and I think that's pretty accurate with what my style is anyway. So if I would just keep it very mechanical and very structure-like, then I will always keep the feeling that it's just not finished. This really just finishes it off for me, and I will use a few different colors of these flowers in here. I think I will change it later on, but you get the idea. I'm making this bush that I will mainly use around the tree, because that is, it is the tree of life, and I want the plant life around the tree to be really pretty, and all the plant life around it will just be a little bit more plain. It could be that I will get back to the sci-fi area at some point. I still want to do something with a battle going around somewhere over here, and maybe have the robot dog. I forgot the name. Mutt-bot? Was that it? I don't know. But I still want that thing in here somewhere, and maybe have a battle with a dragon and some knights, and like I did in the facility. To be somewhere outside here as well. So we'll just, I kind of feel like that should be the last step to just tie everything into each other. We'll have a mothership somewhere, probably around the fantasy area, and we'll have maybe a crashed ship and a mine or something like that in the western area. And to tie everything into each other, we'll probably make stage some sort of battle over here. Now you could see very briefly how it all looks in the dark, and I think that looks just pretty amazing. This still wasn't really finished. Like I said, I will work a little bit more all over the place and just finish everything up that I want to do. Also because this is the last episode and I just kind of finished everything in, I think, about 2 sessions or something. I was just finishing up everything at the same time. So yeah. I didn't really expect it, but in the end it kind of became some sort of magical alien forest with some monuments and a huge facility at the end of it. I quite like it actually, and you can never really plan beforehand what you're gonna do anyway. So I think this is the last thing we're gonna work on before we get to the real-time part. This is where the entertainment point is gonna be. I'm gonna have like a ton of these robots, Dexar robots, going around here. I think I have about 10 of them or maybe more. We're in Sandbox anyway, so... Oh, by the way, I found a pretty cool trick, and it's really not that hard at all, and something that you maybe found out for yourself already, but I was pretty sick of losing all my staff members, so what I did was just pay everyone 1,000 per month, and now everyone is just overjoyed with their job. I do try to level them up a little bit slower, so I think currently all my staff members are at training level 3, so they won't get bored with their job. But yeah, at least my workers are not just quitting anymore and my shops aren't closing anymore. So I will show you in real time how I did that and how that looks. Talking about real time, let's move on. Alright guys, here we are, and first things first is things I changed a little bit afterwards. I placed 2 more of these ships flying over here. Let's see, I did a lot of terraforming like I said I would. I can turn around the camera because I've already been working a little bit on the fantasy area for next episode. But yeah, I placed a few more of these towers all around so the forest doesn't seem so empty. I did want it to be, I just wanted there to be a lot going on. So since we have some fast passes in here as well, before I zoom out, let me just show you how this looks in the dark, because I do really like the look of this. And it's pretty, pretty dark. Hopefully you'll be able to see it well. Yeah, let's just go through here a little bit. So everything is working and set up, and as you can see, it's a little bit laggy. The frame rate is dropping pretty heavily every now and then until I get some freezes. So basically get the idea of how it looks in the dark. Oh, let me turn it back to daytime. Yeah, I said I would make a few more of these pillars, and it's more like lampposts. I didn't use them all over the place because it's already very, there are already a lot of lights just around, so but this thing over here, it's basically just a pillar with another one of these engine thingies and a few of the sci-fi objects in there. I can show you, I think. So it's just this item, my favorite wall attachment that I placed on it and in different heights. Yeah, it looks pretty cool. Maybe I could make a selection of a few of these things that I used in here, because some of it is pretty cool, like the entertainment station, these pillars, maybe some of these flowers, stuff like that. I don't even know if I showed you in real time what I did with the tree and the lights here. I don't even think so. These are all the mushroom lights, and I sank them into the ground, into the tree. So you would only see just a little dot of it, and I basically drew lines with it. And it just looks so awesome. I'm really happy with the result of that. And I kind of wish I would have done the same or something like that for the fantasy area, because yeah, it just looks really cool and would fit there perfectly as well. So let's just start at the beginning here. You come down to this place. You have a lot of plant life around. Let's go this way. Hey, there's the first Dexar. it's pretty cool to have all these sci-fi kind of objects in this magical forest. I think it gives a really nice look to it. Monorail going over there. We have these ships flying around. So I really like the look of this. And like I said before, keeping things simple every now and then just really works well like this. I don't know why, but I just like the look of this so much. It just looks amazing to me. And it wasn't a lot of work at all. It's really simple. If you would recreate it, you could do it in 5 minutes. So yeah, pretty cool. Same for this. And I think I made a information desk in here. So we have these fast passes, and it's closed. I probably didn't do that yet for this one. But let me just show you, let me just show you what I did. For park management, like I said, my staff members, paying all my staff members and making sure they won't quit anymore. We have another one of these rosters, of course, for the sci-fi members. You can see 18 staff members. That's because of all the Dexars. I can show you that as well. Entertainers. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, wow. So, a lot of them, 15. Well, it counts from 2. That's weird. So it's 14. But yeah, really cool. And I paid them all 1,000. Let me just check if there is one between here that I didn't do that for yet. No. It should all be alright, maybe for a vendor, because one just quit. Yeah. This one. Is it this one? Yeah, it is. So you can see I haven't checked it for maybe 2 sessions that I played, and they already quit. So very simple. Just give them 1,000. Oh, my numlock is on. And they won't quit. Training them till level 3. I don't know if it has a lot of influence on if they will quit their jobs anyway, if they are just max level right away. So I will just keep an eye on that and try to upgrade that a little bit slowly. So I don't want them to get bored of their jobs, even though their pay is ridiculously good. I think all of it is just good. So yeah, just pay everyone 1,000 if you're in Sandbox and you're also sick of losing your staff members. This way they are just all very happy. If you look at their thoughts over here as well, it's like this job was made for me, training make everything better. But before that it was something with, I believe, my pay is so good. So let's open the shop back up, because it's still closed and I don't know why. So are you now happy? Yeah, should be happy. I can do more work than this. Oh, there's plants inside of here. But yeah, we have an information shop over here. We have another ATM. Most of the food shops. Oh my god. Stop it. I'm really not good with lag. I get really pissed. And this is nothing compared to when I'm building and it has to load objects. Yeah. I think most of the shops for food and drinks are up here, and I didn't really see a use for it to do more. People do hang around here a lot more. And also the entertainers because of that, but you can see there's quite a bit of them. And this one is broken down. Is somebody getting on that? Let's check. So we have our mechanics. What are you doing? Yeah, he's going there. Good. Oh, he's already there. Good. Fix that. I do really like how this all looks, and the only thing I would just wish was that we had scaling, you know? How easy it would be to create some alien plant life if you could scale them up really big. That's kind of the only thing I wish I could have done differently, you know? We have a lot of these aliens around here as well, before I forget. They are just guarding the place. I will just show you around a little bit more before we call it an episode. They are just chilling around here. I did make this bush with some more of these mushroom lamps inside of it, so they glow. I really love the blue glow, and I could use that just for everything. Why is nobody over here? It is open. That's weird. Nobody's going over here. Why not? I'll figure that out a little bit later. So, we have the Sci-Fi station. That's something that won't be used for a while, since it's not finished until we connect it back to the main street. Now I'm really wondering why nobody's going over here. Oh, I think I might know. I changed the amount of people we can have in our park. Because that is also something that could help a little bit with lag. I think it was it here in overview? Yeah, I did a maximum amount of guests for 1500. I'm probably gonna put that back to a 2000. I think that might be good, but because of all the animations and the lag that I'm experiencing right now, I decided to just put it a little bit lower. So if you have the same problem, this is also something you can do. Just turn down a little bit of the maximum amount of guests. That just really helps with the lag. I will probably put that back the way it was whenever I upgrade my PC. This is still something I'm just really annoyed by, that they just fall down and walk up over here. That's so weird. please Frontier, fix that. That's just crazy. I really don't like that. Such an immersion breaker. I'm starting to ramble on, so this is it for this episode, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to drop a like if you like this video to let me know that you liked it. That were a lot of likes. Subscribe to the channel if you want to see more, if you're new, and be sure to click the notification bell right next to the subscribe button if you want to stay up to date on when our videos are coming out, because that is not something that's just given anymore. Thank you so much, guys, and I'll see you on the next one.